I will just we'll just move the class and we'll try to see all the question all the parts very quickly है ना. गुड मॉर्निंग. ओके सो वी वर इन द मॉर्निंग्स मंडेज क्लास वी वर डूइंग सबसेट्स. सो वी वर डूइंग सबसेट. सो ए बिलोंग्स टू बी. सो वी हैव सीन दिस पार्ट वेयर दिस इज द नोटेशन फॉर सबसेट. विल बी द नोटेशन फॉर सबसेट. सो ऑलवेज द सबसेट विल बी रिप्रेजेंटेड लाइक दिस. सो ए this is the representation of subset. Okay, so that means this is also a set, this is a set, and this is also a set. Okay, and the next notation is this, right? So this is notation means a this means this is an element, this is an element, and this is a set, right? This is known as a is a subset, is a subset of b. And this is known that A is an element. A is an element of B. Element of B. So there is a difference. Okay. I hope everybody understood. Fine. Okay. Sending your trigonometry as we have one day left. Okay. So fine. So I'll just finish this as soon as possible. So this is that A is equals to A and B is equals to A is a subset of B. Know why, and B is a subset of A. Know why. So if A is a subset of B, so they are saying that A is a subset of B, right? So you have to check. You have to check. So let's see A E I O U A B. So A E I O U, right? These are the element of set A, and A B C D is an element of D. So that means A is here. Okay. A E I. So E I O U are not there in B. E I O U not in there in B. So that means we can say E is a, E belongs to A, but E does not belongs to B. So that means A is not a subset. So that means this shows that A is not a subset of B, right? A is not a subset of B. In even if one element is not there in B, you can say that it is not a subset. Second, B is a subset. Again, D belongs to B, but D does not belongs to B, right? D does not belongs to A, but D does not belongs to A. So that means this means again that D is sorry. This does not. This means that B is not a subset of A, because there is one element D which is not present in, which is present in B but not present in A. So you can easily say, you know. Next, interval as a subset of R. Okay, now see interval. We have already discussed about interval. So if on a number line we are defining two values. Suppose A and B. Right, if on a number line and defining two values, so these will be the different kind of intervals we can write. So first is interval like this. Second is interval like this. Third is interval like this, and fourth is interval like this. And this is A comma B. Right? What does this mean? This means all elements. This means all elements in between a and b, including a and b, all elements between a and b, including a and b. Understood? Second one, this is all elements between a and b, excluding a and b. This one is all elements between a and b, including b. This is all elements between A and B, including A. I hope this everybody understood, right? I hope everybody understood. है ना? This one is everybody is able to understood. Now next part. Okay, so this is the same thing. In this case, A and B both are not included. Every element between A and B is included, but A and B not included. In this case, A and B are included. So the representation will be open dot, this blank dot, and this dot. है ना? So this is filled dot. So this is A and B included. Here only A is included. Here only B is included, right? Okay, I hope you understood. Kanish, sorry, Sanjay, Mr. Bache, slide I will show you afterwards. Hai na? Now, power set. Power set is simply see. Power set is a collection of all the sets. Power set basically is what? Power set is a collection of all the sets which can be formed as a proper set. So suppose if there is any set which is given to you, right? So first you have to find all possible sets, right? So suppose you have a set given. So set you have been given as A is equals to. So set you have been given as suppose set A is given to you as element 1 comma 2, right? So first power set is what? Power set is the collection, is a set of all the possible subsets of A. Power set is simply a set of all possible subsets of A. So how can you find all the possible subsets? So for A, the possible subset will be first empty set, second will be taking individually one, then individually two, these all are subsets, then last one is including 1, 2, right? So that means the power set, the cardinal number of power set will be simply the elements, whatever elements are there. So this is 2 to the power n. So suppose a set A has 3 elements, 1, 2, 3. So the power set, number of subsets, the power set will contain how many elements? 2 to the power 3. That means 8 elements. Understood? For this one, it is 2 to the power 2. That is 4. Understood? Suppose it is only one element. A has only one element, 1. So what will be the power set? 2 to the power 1, that is 1. That is first set will be empty set, second set will be complete. So this is the power set. I hope everybody understood. This power set has 2 elements. First is empty set, second is the set which contains only one element. So this is the power set. And everybody knows this. Next. Universal set. Universal set is what? By universal set is simply a set which contains all the elements. And This universal set is very much dependent on the question. So it is only in respect to a question. This is only in respect with respect to a question. Yes, this is only with respect to a particular question. For example, if I'm talking about in a question, set A, which has the element 1, 2, 3, set B, which has element 2, 3, 4, right? Set C, which has element 5, 6, 7. Universal set I can represent with U. Universal set I can write as universal set is natural numbers. Hai na? Universal set I can also write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I can also write like this. Universal set I can also write first 10 natural numbers. So that is 1, 2, 10. Universal set I can also write 1 to 20. So it is depending on a particular question. Universal set here can be represented only in a perspective of a particular question. So if a question is given universal set is natural number, then you will take this as a natural number, universal set. Universal set is given this one will be an universal set. Universal set is this one. But the thing is, universal set should contain all the elements of that particular question. So this cannot have, suppose universal set is this one, hai na? Universal set is suppose this one, and this C also has 21, then this cannot be the universal set. Universal set has to contain this 21 for it to become a universal set. I hope this everybody understood. Universal set will contain all the possible elements of all the sets for that particular question. I hope this one everybody is able to understand. Yes, next question, next sheet. Venn diagram, hai na? So Venn diagram is basically pictorically or graphically represent any two sets. So suppose you have two sets. Set A is given as 1, 2, and 3, and set B is given as 2, 3, and 4. And universal set is given 1 to 10. 1 to 10. Okay, so what I will do for universal set, I will represent like this. So universal set I will represent like this. So this is universal set. I will first draw A. So A has how many elements? 1 2 3. 1 2 3. B has how many elements? 2 3 4. So B has elements 2 3 4. So this is A and this is B. This means that in between A and B, how many elements are common? In between A and B, the elements are common are 2 and 3. Hai na? Then how many elements are left out? A, 1, 2, 3, 4. How many left elements are left out? So this will be 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So these all elements are in universal set. These all the elements are in A. These all elements are in B. Okay. These all elements are in A and these all elements are in B. Okay. Now see, for same question, for this, I hope this one everybody understood what is Venn diagram. This is known as Venn diagram. This is known as Venn diagram. Fine. Next. So let's see. Union of a set. So union of a set is what? Union of a set will be represented as A union B. Union of a set will be represented as A union B, right? So see, suppose in the previous question, this is A and this is B. So this is A, this is B. Hai na? This is universal set. So this was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hai na? So suppose you have been taken, you have to take A union B. Hai na? So A union B means what? All the elements in which are in A or B, which are in set A or set B. That means all the elements, collection of all the elements which are either set A or B or both. Hai na? So that means what will be the value of A union B? A union will be 1, 2, 3 and 4. This is the union of two sets. All the elements only counted once. So union of set will not be like this. 1, 2, 3, 2, 3 and 4. Because we know that one element we can write only once. So this will be the union of two sets. Hai na? This will be the union of two sets. Suppose we have set this thing like this. So we have suppose three different sets. So this is A, this is B, this is C. So these elements are suppose written like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So if somebody asking what is A union B, what will be A union B? So all the elements which are contained in A and B only. So this will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right? What will be A union C? A union C will be 1, 2, 3, 6, 1, 2, 3, 6, 8, 7, 9, 10. Right? What will be A union B union C? By A union B will be simply shaded like this. A union B will be simply shaded by this. You shade A and you shade B. This is A union B. A union B will be shaded like this. What will be A union C? A union C will be A and C. Shade complete A and C. Hai na? Understood? So this is 5 is also. 5 is also here. 5 is also here. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hai na? Yeah, 5 is also there. Then A union B union C will be 1 to 10. Simply 1 to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I hope everybody understood. I have everybody understood these two examples. This is very simple. Everybody understood, right? This you have already done. Hai na? Very good. Now, then find A union B. What will be the A union B? A union B. What will be the A union B? 2, 4, 6, 8. I will write it once. Then 6, 8 is also there. 10 and 12. Simple as that. Hai na? Simply you just write this. You can represent it using Venn diagram. So you have A, you have B, you have A, you have B, 6, 8, 2, 4, 10, 12, simply. Hai na? Very good. Now, intersection of set. Intersection of set is what? Suppose the previous example, if I'll take. So this is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. This complete portion was union. This complete portion was union. Simply, intersection will be those elements which are in A as well as in B. So this will be represented by A intersection B. Intersection means the elements which are in A as well as B, which are in A as well as B. है ना. ओके आई हैव एवरीबॉडी अंडरस्टूड. सो इन दिस केस इट इज 6,8 है ना. इफ आई टेक द प्रीवियस एग्जाम्पल वॉट इन दिस एग्जाम्पल वॉट इज ए इंटरसेक्शन बी. What is A intersection B for this one? What is A intersection B for this one? 3,6. है ना? What is A intersection C for this one? What is A intersection C for this one? What is A intersection C for this one? By what is A intersection? 6, 7 and 8. By A intersection C will be this part. Whatever is in A in C. 6, 7, 8. Very good. What will be C intersection B? C intersection B. What will be C intersection B? 6 and 5. है ना. C intersection C will be 6 and 5. Understood? Anirudh, did you understood? Anirudh, did you understood? It's not just 5. It is 6 and 5. है ना. Everybody understood? है ना. Very good. Okay. I hope this one is clear. So intersection also we have seen. है ना. Okay. So these are the different shaded portion. This will be B union C. See, complete B set and complete C set. Complete B set and complete C set. So this will be B union C. This is A intersection B. A intersection B. Completely forget about C. If A intersection B is asked, completely forget about C. So if it's completely forget about that, okay, there is C existing also. For A intersection B, just remember A and B. For A intersection B, just completely remember A and B. Completely forget about C. You do not even have to remember what is. Hai na? So this will be like this. Understood? Fine. Fine. Okay. So this is A intersection B union C. This will be A intersection B. A intersection B union C. B union C will be completely this part. B union C will be completely this part. A intersection will be only this part. The part which is common with A and B. Hai na? So I hope this one everybody is able to understood. Hai na? Next. Difference of set. Difference of set, you can, this is actually removed. So I think we can skip for this, for today's class. We can skip because this is removed from syllabus. Okay, I think this is removed from syllabus, but we can remove from this part, this class. Okay, so I hope everybody is able to understand very quickly what we did today. I hope everybody is able to understand very quickly what we did today. Yes, complement is also removed. That is why I have not taken complement also. Okay, so now let's. So which part? Okay, fine. Okay, so now just wait. Array, what happened? Just wait for a second. Okay, so next is we will start with relations and functions. Okay, next is we will start with relations and function. Yes, so I will start with relations and function. Okay, I hope the a PDF is visible to everybody. Relation and function, this is visible to everyone. Yes? Yes? Ha, okay. So let's start with relation and function. Okay. So first thing is, by introduction, by C, we have difference in... Yes. So for relation and function, we see first thing is that introduction, we already know. Hana, why do we need a relation and function? So from two different sets. So first is from two different sets. Combination of two different sets, how they are related, then we'll see, okay, relation and function. The first thing is, screen is not visible, but it is visible to all, right? Can you see this relation and function as a slide? Yes, huh. Everybody is able to see. Yeah, very good, very good. Okay, so now see, first thing we'll move on to Cartesian product. So Cartesian product is simply when we are talking about from two different sets. When we are talking about two different sets, you know. So if we have two different sets, just wait. Huh. So when we are talking about two different sets, you know. So suppose you have set A. And you have set A and set B. Set A is given as, so suppose set A is given as 2,3 and set B is, or just wait. Just wait for a second. Okay, so Cartesian product. See, for two different sets. Okay, so Cartesian product. See, when you have two sets, suppose set A is given as 2, 3, and set B is given as 3, 4, right? So what you will do, you can imagine this as in this case. So set A you write as 2, 3, and set B you write as 3, 4. Then write all possible combination Cartesian product from set A to set B. So Cartesian product from set A to set B. So first you write set A, then set B. So all possible combination. So 2, 3. 2, 3 is possible. है ना, 2, 4 is possible. 2, 4 is possible. Then 3, 3 is possible and 3, 4 is possible. So all possible combination from set A to set B. How we will read? This 2 is coming from set A. This 2 is coming from set A. This 2 is coming from set B. This 2 is coming from set B. This 2 is, sorry, 3 is coming from set B. This 2 is coming from set A. This 4 is coming from set B. This 3 is coming from set A. This 3 is coming from set B. Then this 3 is coming from set A. This is coming from set B. If suppose it was B cross A. If suppose it was B cross A, then you would have written B first and A second. Then it would have been 3, 4, 2, 3. Then 3, 2, 3, 3. Then 3, 2, 3, 3. And 4, 2, and 4, 3. So this will be simply Cartesian product. Cartesian product is always written in this form. Cartesian product is always written in this form, where this 3, 2, where this A, B is known as ordered pair. Where this A, B is known as ordered pair. What is A, B? See here. Suppose you have A, B, and the product is from A to B. And so this whole thing is known as ordered pair. Ordered pair. What? Why ordered pair? Because this A is coming from. This is an ordered pair. Why? Because this A is coming from set A, and this B is coming from coming from set B. Right? This we have already seen. है ना, दिस वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन, दिस वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन वंस बिफोर, है ना, सो वी आर जस्ट रिवाइजिंग इट, है ना, सो ए इज कमिंग फ्रॉम सेट ए, बी इज कमिंग फ्रॉम सेट बी, इज देयर एनी डाउट फ्रॉम हियर, एंड सपोज इफ इट वाज बी क्रॉस ए, इफ इट इज बी क्रॉस ए एंड दिस इज A, B, देन दिस ए इज कमिंग फ्रॉम विच सेट, ए इज कमिंग फ्रॉम विच सेट, नाउ ए इज कमिंग फ्रॉम, नाउ दिस ए इज कमिंग फ्रॉम विच सेट, ए इज कमिंग फ्रॉम सेट बी, है ना, एंड दिस बी इज कमिंग फ्रॉम विच सेट, दिस बी इज कमिंग फ्रॉम set A. Everybody understood? Yes. Suppose it was C cross D and this was written as A, B. So now this A is coming from which set? A is coming from which set? C. This B is coming from which set? D. Everybody understood? Yes. Very good. Excellent. And so this is a Cartesian product and ordered pair. Fine. Okay. Then we will move on to, okay. Let's see this question. Let's solve this question. Okay, now tell me, so first thing you have to find the Cartesian product of P cross Q and Q cross P, hai na? P cross Q and Q cross P, right? So P cross Q, let's see, P is ABC, so we'll have ABC and here we have R, right? And Q cross P, so Q is R and ABC. So what will be P cross Q? AR, BR, CR. This will what? P cross Q. Hai na? And Q cross P will be RA, RB, RC. Right? Are these two equal? These two are not equal. Why? Because A, R is not equals to R, A. AR is not equals to R, A. If this everybody understood? Yeah. Hai na? Interchange places. Yeah. Now this is AR. This, if somebody says that AR is equals to RA. If somebody says that AR is equals to RA, that means what does this signify? R is equals to A. Very good. Excellent, Bachcha. Do you remember? Yes. Very good. Understood? For a simple example, one more simple example. Suppose they have given ordered pair X plus 2, 4 is equals to 5, Y plus 3. Then tell me what is the value of X? X is equals to 3. What is the value of Y? Y is equals to 1. y is equals to 1. Very good. Understood. Hai na? Everybody understood? Yes. Very good. Excellent. 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 Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. This is very good. Very good. Ha, relation. Now see, for relation. Okay. Hai na? See, now when we are talking about two different sets, hai na? When we are talking about two different sets, so these two sets were, suppose if I'm writing set A is written and set B is written, set A is written 1, 2, 3, 4 and set B is written, set A has these elements and set B is written 1, 4, 9 and 16. And I'm linking these two sets as like this. I'm linking these two sets as like this. Hai na? Then I can say that by A is related to B set, or A is related to B, or set B is related to A with some particular relation. They have a common relation between them. So what will be this? So relation I am writing as, relation I am writing as, again same way in set in roster form, or set builder form, sorry. So I will write as A comma B, hai na? A comma B, where A belongs to A and B belongs to set B. A belongs to A and B belongs to set B. And what is the relation between A and B? B is equals to A square. Right? See? So, this relation will contain what elements? 1, 1. Okay? Then 2, 4. Then 3, 9. Then 4, 16. This everybody understood? This everybody understood? Now see, if I'll write relation like this, relation is equals to A, B. A, B. Now see, there is because set builder is easy to represent, set builder is easy to represent, and this is roster form, this is set builder form, this is set builder form, builder form, and what is this? This is roster form. Hai na? Understood? Okay, fine. This is R is equals to A comma B. R is equals to A comma B. Now see very carefully see what I'm doing. A belongs to B and B belongs to A, hai na? such that A is equals to B square. A is equals to B square, hai na? Then tell me what will be the elements. In this is set builder form, what will be the roster form? First element, what will be the roster form? 1, 1 will be first, yes. Next one will be 4, 2. Very good. Next one will be 9, 3. Next one will be 16, 4. Everybody understood? By B, A is equals to B square. A is equals to B square. Hai na? A is belonging to which? This A element is belonging to set B and B is belonging to set A. Understood? Simply, everybody understood? Just I have reversed. Hai na? B belongs to A, yes. Sorry, B belongs to set A. Sorry, this is set A. B belongs to set A. Hai na? Understood? Fine. I hope this one is okay. Fine. Very good. Okay. So I hope this part is everybody is okay for everyone also. Okay. Ha. Let's take one more example. Somebody was saying that relation, suppose this is set A, 1, 2, 3, and this is set B, 5, 6, 7. Then relation, find the elements of relation A comma B such that A belongs to A and B belongs to B such that A is less than equals to B. A is less than equals to B. Then tell me what will be the elements of this set. First you write the elements of this set. First write down the elements of this set and just check whether it is correct or not. A is less than equals to B. Right? So first is, I will check for A. So this is A. A, 1 can be linked with 5, 6, 7. 1 can be linked with 5, 6, 7. So 1, 5, 1, 6, 1, 7. Right? 2 can be linked with 5, 6, 7. 2, 5, 2, 6, and 2, 7. But 3 can be linked with 5, 6, 7. 3, 5, 3, 6, and 3, 7. Right? Then can I say that is this relation R is equals to A cross B? Is this relation R is equals to the Cartesian product of A and B? is relation R is equals to Cartesian product of A and B. Yes, everybody understood? Fine. Now suppose, yes, okay. Now suppose if set A was 1, 2, 3 and set B was 1, 3, 2. 1, 3, 2. And they have given relation is equals to A, comma B such that A belongs to capital A, B belongs to capital B and A is less than B such that A is less than B. Then tell me what are the elements of set A, this set R? What are the elements of this set R? Tell me what are the elements of this set R. A is less than equals to A is less than B. A is less than B. So 1 is less than 3 and 2. So 1 is less than 3. 1 is less than 2. Right? Next, 2. 2 is less than which element? 2 is less than 1? No. 2 is less than 2? No. 2 is less than 3. So 2, comma 3. 3 is less than anyone? No. These are the elements. 1, 3, 1, 2, 2, 3. Everyone understood? Fine. That's all. Hai na? Very good. So I hope everybody understood these two parts. Yes? Hai na? Very good. Okay. Okay. Very good. Okay. Now see, this was relation, right? Function is a special kind of relation. Right. So next concept is function. Okay. So function is a special kind of relation which satisfies two very specific properties. So function is a special relation which satisfies two very special properties, right? So obviously it is a function. So what we'll say, we'll have two different sets. Function will have obviously two different sets. So suppose this is set A, this is set B. Set A has elements A, B, C, and set B has elements 1, 2, 3, 4, suppose. Hai na? Okay. So function will satisfy two very specific properties. First property is that no element from set A should be left out. Okay, should be left out. First property is no element from set A should be left out. That means every element from set A should be linked with one element from B. Hai na? So that means this can be the case. This can be the case by all elements of set A are linked. Set A, hai na, is linked with one, at least some element of B. Hai na? This is the first condition. With first condition, I can make this diagram. Second condition for the function is every element from set A should be linked with only one element of set B. First condition was every element should be left out. That means suppose I will make this, right? But here second condition says that every element of set A should be linked with only one element. So A is linked with two. So that means I will move. So this is now the perfect example of function. This is not the perfect example of function. A is linked with only one. B is linked with only one. C is linked with only one. So what will be the relation function? So suppose I'm writing this with F. So F will be, suppose this is the function F. So element of F will be A, 1, B, 4 and C, 2. A, 1, B, 4 and C, 2. A is linked with 1. B is linked with 4. C is linked with 2. Right? So this is the proper perfect example of a function. I hope everybody understood. Yes, I have this till here. Nobody is saying that B cannot be linked. Hai na? Nobody is saying that B, no element of B cannot be left alone. No, they are only saying A, element of A should be linked and only once. एलिमेंट ऑफ ए शुड बी लिंक्ड एंड ओनली वंस, है ना. बी बी नोबडी केयर्स अबाउट बी, बी इज यूजलेस, है ना, बी इज यूजलेस, है ना. सो नाउ सम टर्म्स, नाउ सम टर्म्स रिलेटेड टू दिस. सो दिस इज सपोज सेट ए एंड दिस इज सपोज सेट बी, राइट. सो आई एम राइटिंग ए बी सी 1 2 3 4, है ना. सो दिस इज सपोज दीज आर लिंक्ड लाइक दिस एंड दिस इज लाइक दिस, है ना. सो दिस सेट ए, this set A is known as the domain. This set A is known as the domain. Domain is the values which can be taken inside the function, है ना? The values which can be taken inside the function. Okay. Now this set B is known as the codomain. Codomain. Right? This known as the codomain. है ना? This is yeah domain or you can say the input. And codomain is known as the possible output. Possible output. Right, but what are actually the output? If I'm taking A, what is the output? 1. If I'm taking B, what is the output? 1. If I'm taking C, what is the output? 3. So the only possible, so on the only output we are getting are these two values, 1 and 3. So this 1 and 3 collectively, this set 1 comma 3 will be known as the range. Range are those values of codomain which are actually given in the output, which are actually given as output. Okay, so I have everybody understood. So suppose I will call this as A comma 1 and B comma 1 and C comma 3. So this will be the function. This is the function. Hai na? One more thing. This 1 is known as the image of A. 1 is the image of A. I will write 1 is the image of A. Okay, one is the image of A, and A is the pre-image of one. One is the image of A, and A is the pre-image of one. Okay, so what is the image of C? What is the image of C? What will be the image of C? What will be the image of C? Tell me what will be the image of C. Very good. Tell me what is the image of B? What is the image of B? One. What is the pre-image of one? 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 By pre-image of one, it two elements, A and B. Hai na? What is the pre-image of three? What is the pre-image of three? What is the pre-image of three? Very good. What is the pre-image of two? What is the pre-image of two? What is the pre-image of two? No pre-image. Hai na? Nothing. Pre-image of 2 is nothing. There is no pre-image of 2. So, okay, everybody understood? Suppose if I'll take one more example. Very good. A, B, C, D, E. A, B, C, D, E. And this is suppose B. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hai na? So, tell me. Is this a function? Is this a function? Yes or no? Is this a function? Is this a function? Is it a function? Right now, is it a function? Why? Because this 2 is linked with more than. Very good, very good. Hai na? So now tell me, what is a domain? What is a domain? What is a domain? What is a domain of this? What is the domain of the set? A, B, C, D, E. What is the range? What is the range? Range is 1. 2, 3, 5, right? And what is a codomain? What is a codomain? Codomain is complete set B. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This everybody understood? Fine. Very good. Very good. This is very simple. Range will always be a subset. The range will always be a subset of codomain. Codomain. Right? Range will always be a subset of codomain. Fine. Very good. Okay. Next. Next. Okay. Then they have drawn some, you will be having some graphs of the function. Okay. Okay. Then you have, range is wrong. Range, what is the range? 1, 2, 3, 5. 1 through 3, 5. Sir, please tell whether the range are image to some elements. All range will always have a pre-image. All range will always have a pre-image, or they will always be image of something, because otherwise they cannot be range. Range will all elements of range, hai na, will always be a pre-image. Hai na? Next, they have given you some function, modulus function. Should I explain modulus function? Should I explain modulus function? Modulus function everybody knows. Acha, okay, okay, fine, fine. Where is it? Wait, I will explain. Huh. So this is modulus function. Yeah. So then you have some different functions, hai na? So modulus function is very simple. It is represented by f of x is equals to modulus of x. This is the operator. This is modulus operator. This function is basically, we can define this function into two parts. F of x will be simply plus x when x is greater than 0 or equal to 0, and minus x when x is less than 0. So if I'll try to draw the function, it will be simply just like this. For x greater than 0, it is phi is equals to x. For x less than 0, it is y is equals to minus x. So this will be the modulus function. Modulus function is always greater than or equal to 0. Modulus function is always greater than equal to 0. Sir, you did not tell about domain and range or of relation. Just now I told, Rajesh Pache. What you're talking about. Just now you were discussing domain and range. So what will be the domain of modulus function? Tell me, what is the domain of modulus function? Domain of modulus function. Tell me, what is the domain of modulus function? Domain of modulus function will be R. That means it can take all possible values, all possible real values, hai na? Real values, hai na? Okay. Tell me, what will be the range of greatest integer x? What is the range of greatest integer x? It will be range. Can modulus function take 0? No. So range will be 0 to infinity. Positive, or we will say not just positive, we will say non-negative real numbers. Not whole numbers. Whole numbers only contain 0, 1, 2. In between this, you can have 1.1, but whole number does not contain 1.1. So whole number is not the correct answer. Understood? Bala, did you understood the difference? Yes? R plus will also include. So you can also write this as R plus plus 0. Because R plus will start from, R plus will be 0 to infinity, plus you can write 0. Okay? Fine. You can say positive rational number will be this will be positive rational. Not even positive rational number. By root 2 will also be taken. You cannot say positive rational is also not correct. Positive rational number is also not correct. Understood? It should be positive real numbers, including 0, or non-negative real numbers. Non-negative real numbers is the best answer. Understood? Fine. Okay. Next is signum function. Next is your signum function. A signum function is. So suppose you have signum function. So signum function is simply if. So signum function is represented as this operator signum of x, right? This is f of x. So signum function. What I'm going to practice some very tricky questions. We had practiced someone during last session. Equation like that come in exam. Greatest integer function graph is there, for example. So this is yes, but functions graph will be there, hai na? So these all are part of your NCRT, and these are, we have done many times. So this is signum function. Signum function will only return positive when x is greater than 0. This will become positive 1 when x is greater than 0. This will become 0 when x is equal to 0, and will return minus 1 when x is less than 0. So this is somewhat like I taught this before. So what this is, don't tell me that I have not taught. I teach everything. Okay. So don't say, Devdarshan, don't say that I'm not taught this before and I'm not taught this, because I've taught you whole functions. So don't say, don't ever blame me this just now what you have said. So this is x is greater than 0. If you can check the notes, I've taught this before. I remember, bache, because NCRT, though I've... Okay, fine. It's okay. So x greater than 0, it will be plus 1. This is somewhat similar to the modulus function. Modulus function, what does it do? Modulus function will simply a modulus function will simply return the positive value. Modulus function will modulus function will simply return the positive value. So suppose if a modulus function, so modulus function x, suppose x is 0.1, so x is 0.1, so modulus function will return 0.1. but signum function, if x is equals to 0.1, signum function will return 1, because 0.1 is positive. So signum function will return positive 1 value. Suppose if greatest integer x, for x is equals to minus 0.1, this will return what? Minus 0.1, greatest integer, modulus function, this will return 0.1 only. But signum function of x, when x is equals to minus of 0.1, this will return what? Minus 1. And so if I will try to draw the graph of this one, signum function, it's a very simple graph. For right hand side, it is plus 1. For left hand side, it is minus 1. And for middle, it is just 1. And so I will just use this one. So this is like this. And here it is perfect dot. And for plus, yes. For plus, it is right side. For minus, it is minus 1. So this is y is equals to plus 1. This is y is equals to minus 1. And this is y is equals to 0. Okay. So only this will be the signum function. I hope everybody understood. Right? I hope everybody understood. So tell me. Okay. Let's see. One example from this we can write. Signum function of x square. Tell me what will be the signum function of... Draw the signum function of x square. No. There is one mistake. Yes, Girish, that is what. Yes. Now you understood. So signum function of x square. So this will be like this. This is y is equals to 1. But so this is something like this. Right? So for 0, it will be 0. So this is 0, 0. This is everywhere else, it will be y is equals to 1. Left side, it will be y is equals to 1. But at just one point, 0, 0, it will be 0. Understood? Understood, Bala? Very good. Everybody understood, I hope. Everybody understood signum function? Yes or no? Are bache, for x square, it is always positive. For x greater than, by x square is always positive. X square is greater than 0 for all x real positive. X square is greater than 0 for all x belongs to real negative. For real negative, for real positive, it is always greater than 0. For real positive and negative, it is always greater than 0 because it is a square. Right, it will only be equal to 0, x is equal to 0 only when x is equal to 0. So for right hand side, it is positive, so 1. For left side, it is positive, so 1. Only it is 0 when x is equal to 0. Understood? Yes. Now I hope everybody understood. By right hand side, it is positive, left side. Sir, why have you taken 1 as the value of y? Because it is the definition of signum function. What is it? That is the definition of signum function. Tell me what is the signum function for modulus of x. Tell me what will be the signum function for modulus of x. What will the signum function for modulus of x? Will you have exactly same as this? Yes. Will you have exactly same? Yes. R plus 1, R minus 1, and yes. Okay. Fine. Suppose I am giving signum function of minus of x square. What will the signum function of minus of x square? Signum function of minus of x square. Tell me, will it be something like this? Is it something like this? This is y is equals to minus 1. Hena? Yes? Understood? Yes? So for... a plus, it will be minus. Understood? Everybody understood? Now it will be like this. Because now everywhere it will be negative except one value. So this value will be 0, comma 0. Only when it is 0, it will be 0. Otherwise, everywhere it will be negative. I hope this one is okay. Signum function is okay. Yes, very good. Okay, let's see other function. Modulus, we have done greatest integer. Greatest integer function. So we have to do greatest integer now. Let's see greatest integer function. Okay, see, so greatest integer function is, we have already seen, I've already taught you what is greatest integer function. It will only represent the greatest integer value. It will only represent the integral value of whatever it is. So we have seen 0.1. What will be the greatest integer? So greatest integer function will be represented by this operator. So greatest integer f of x is equals to, this is the representation of greatest integer function. F of x, this is the representation of greatest integer, also known as this step function. Step function. This is the greatest integer function. Okay. So suppose the function is 0.1. So what will be the value? What will be the value of greatest integer? 0. Suppose it is 1.1. What will be the greatest in, what will the value? 1. Suppose it is 1.999. What will be the greatest integer value? 1. Suppose it is 2.999. What is the greatest integer value? 2. Suppose it is -1.1. What will be the greatest integer value? -1.1, -2. Suppose it is -0.1. What is the greatest integer value? -1. Suppose it is -3.999. What is the greatest integer value? -4. Everybody understood? Suppose it is -0.999. What is the greatest integer value? 0. Everybody understood? If I'll represent this in terms of graph, this everybody remembers, and this was a very interesting function. This will be something like this. Represented as step function because it looks like steps. It looks like somebody has made steps. So this is excluded. This is excluded. This is excluded. This is excluded. This is included. 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 Right, so this is x is equals to 1, x is equals to 2, x is equals to 3, this is x is equals to -1, this is x is equals to -2, and so on. Everybody understood? It is a step function, yes, because it looks like a step. Okay, fine. So tomorrow we will discuss some questions on trigonometry. Okay, I want you to revise the remaining graphs and remaining functions of function concept chapter. So remaining functions of concept function chapter, we'll discuss tomorrow. We'll see the remaining we'll discuss the remaining functions from functions. I think almost all of them are done. So tomorrow we'll solve with trigonometry. We'll see whatever maximum thing which we can done in trigonometry tomorrow. Okay. So I'll share with you the PDF now. I hope everybody understood. Okay, I will share the both revision 1 and revision 2. Okay, by see, if you are doing whatever I was teaching previously, if you are doing that religiously every day, you are studying something, this exam will be nothing for you. You will get 100% marks in the exam. If you have been doing whatever I've been teaching every day, this exam will be nothing for you. It's a very simple exam. So you are a living example of reading last 1 hour. It also seems like 5 minutes or something. We should know how to draw the graph of the function. Yes, bachcha. Signum is very easy. Wherever you have plus, you will plus one. Wherever. Sir, we still have 24 degrees. Nice. I will not well that day. It's okay, bachcha. It's okay. Okay, I had rash. We can say that subset of equal sets are the same. Subset and equal set. No. Subset can be different. Equal set will have almost same number of elements. Subset might have less or equal. Suppose 1 is a subset of a set which contains 1, 2. Understood, Kanish? Suppose a set A has only one element, 1, and set B has two elements, 1, 2. Then A will be a subset. But they are not equal set. ओके फाइन ओके आई विल ट्राई टू टेक सम टेक वन एक्स्ट्रा क्लास है ना, आई विल ट्राई टू टेक सम एक्स्ट्रा क्लास ऑन सैटरडे, आई विल ट्राई टू टेक वन क्लास ऑन सैटरडे, आई विल रिक्वेस्ट देम ओके, आई विल टेक सम 2 आवर क्लास एंड वी विल व्हाट एवर इज लेफ्ट आउट वी विल डू सम मिसलेनियस एग्जाम्पल्स ओके, दैट इज ओके फाइन, हाँ दैट विल बी ग्रेट, या ओके आई विल आस्क देम है ना, ओके फाइन, चलो टेक केयर नाउ, आई हैव शेयर द पीडीएफ ओके फाइन ओके, चलो थैंक यू वेरी मच, टेक केयर ओके.